Яблоко.
Привет, друзья! Here I am at a very interesting place today with a very special meaning to me. I am at the El Monte Tank Museum, and behind me the actual tank. This is the actual tank that I operated when I was with the 82nd Airborne. That's my tank. Three, that is my tank, the M551 Sheridan. And today, with the help of my GoPro, because my other camera's not working right now, we're gonna take a tour around the El Monte Tank Museum, which is kind of a small display, but has a lot of stuff crammed in here. So let's go check it out, huh? Decided to break at the right time. Right behind me is one of the trucks I used to drive in the National Guard. This is an M813 5-ton cargo, and right next to it is an M35A1, and it's an A. You can tell it's an A1 because it doesn't have the exhaust pipe right next to it. And right next to it is a World War II amphibious truck, a DUKW. M275, which was a little before my time. Welding shop van. And maybe you've seen these trucks. A lot of these were used in the Lend-Lease during the war. A lot of these vehicles I didn't drive in the Army. I think I'd see one of these again. M60A1 tank. And that gizmo that's right there is a Gamma Goat, which I've seen so many of. This was the type of tank that I trained on, though, in the Army. M48A3, I believe. Nope, A1. Still, kind of, yeah. And then we have an M47.
And I think everybody knows what these tanks are. Gets me right there. Jeeps, Humvees. That one's a Clack Ton River right there. That one also runs on gas. Another M60. Gunnery target mock-up right there. I remember seeing those when I was out in the tank. And, oh, look, I drove these in the guard as well. Dodge. Parts for the Nimitz. I remember driving these too. These were fun. Never drove one of those.
They're wet. I used to deal when I was in LA.
sad thing I'm noticing about all these vehicles, or at least a lot of them, is they are in sad disrepair. Some of them, like this bus, obviously in this half track, you know, they're taken care of, they're well kept, but you know, on that same factor, I think with the way things are here in the United States today, unlike Russia, it's just, it's sad that it's sad that America doesn't take more pride in their military history, you know, like Russia does. I mean, I can't swing a bat and not see a T-34 or a monument to the war in Russia at all, in any video. But sometimes they do try. Yes, I'm going back over here to see my tank again. But I can say this much, as I'm looking at a lot of this equipment, it's, you get a lot of the non-combat equipment, train, and then you get some foreign stuff like this kangaroo, and then these recovery vehicles. Another truck I used to drive in the garden. As a matter of fact, I lived in these things. This is an M818 truck trailer version with a M275 tanker behind it. Magnificent things. Oh, Smotri. It's a helicopter. UH-1 Huey. Flew in those too. Personnel carriers. That one has an entry. That was used in a Bob Hope movie. Six millimeter recoilless rifle. LAPD's famous battering ram. This thing made so much controversy in the 80s. was a quick, short visit at the El Monte Military Vehicle Museum. I'd like to thank the volunteers here for letting me roam around and seeing all this at least saved. Some of it, of course, has been preserved. A lot of it's just been saved from the scrapper's torch. And I have links in the description of the museum's website and the address as well, if anybody wants to come down and see it when you're here in the States, or for some of you here in the States to come to California. I'm a little emotional right now. It's like seeing a long lost relative when you see your tank. And I know it's kind of weird seeing your tank, but I think some of the older Russian treadheads would recognize their tanks, and it was just, it really gets me right here. And I might come up for a future visit and actually try and climb inside the tank. I hear she's been gutted. But it would be nice to sit in the old girl just one more time, and maybe, just maybe, and I doubt it, but maybe in a future episode I can just fire it up to hear that old girl purr. But anyways, as always, Thursia, Yalbatol, and Hank, and Pakak.